You're watching UNICEF Television. December 16, 2009. Guillermo Lopez and Maribel Agustin realize their 4-year-old son Kenneth is missing.
We thought he was playing with children in the neighborhood, but hours went by and nothing happened. So we tried and tried to look for him, and our neighbors helped us. But then night fell and we started losing hope, because he had never been gone for so long.
72 hours pass before police begin their search for Kenneth. 4 days later, he is found buried in a neighbor's backyard whom the family was acquainted with.
These women came to live in the house about 5 months before, and one of them had children the same age, so we never thought they'd be capable of doing something like this. She even had a criminal record, which we found out later. She had kidnapped her own niece. We even helped them with little things they needed, like food.
Guatemala has one of the highest violent crime rates in Latin America. In the first 7 months of 2011, more than 40 murders were reported each week in Guatemala City alone.
Kids would often go missing in the community, but it was a hush-hush thing. Nobody would say anything. Sometimes they would file a claim of a missing person, but the authorities did nothing.
The two women who lived next door to the Lopez family were convicted and sentenced to 50 years in prison without parole. But for Guillermo and Maribel, that wasn't enough. They wanted to stop this from happening to another child. Together, with UNICEF and the Survivors Foundation, they spearheaded a campaign to pass the Alba Kenneth Alert System, a national law in honor of Kenneth and another child, Alba España, who had also been abducted and murdered. The law, modeled after the Amber Alert in the United States, mandates authorities to conduct a search immediately once a child is reported missing.
The disappearance of Kenneth and his death shook the national conscience in Guatemala. It got the attention of the political class and society to react to the need of finding a missing child and preventing the death and abuse of a child.
Before the law was passed, child kidnappings and selling children off for illegal adoption was very common. Murders like Alba's and Kenneth still do happen, but less so since the law was passed.
Since the law went into effect in August of 2010, the Alba Kenneth Alert System has greatly aided authorities in finding missing children.
This is why we've pressed the authorities to immediately start the search once the missing person report is filed. Because if the law had been in effect when Kenneth was abducted, maybe he'd still be alive.
Today, Guillermo Lopez continues to work with families in his son's memory. He conducts identity registration workshops with parents and their children in local schools. These identity registration cards made by UNICEF asks parents to record important information about their children so that authorities have the most recent information available in the event a child goes missing.
These workshops are important because the information is shared in public schools and with parents and teachers, because he, better than anybody else, can explain the content of the law in layman's terms.
Low birth registration rates have been a serious problem in Guatemala. Without proper identification, it is impossible for authorities to find children if they're abducted.
We're training authorities and citizens, and even community councils, so they know that this law has been approved, and they can get help from the authorities if needed. So I train them to let them know that there is a law that protects the rights of children and children's lives.
Being part of the Alba Kenneth Alert System has helped us. When an alert is issued, we feel like it's us all over again. We can relate to the pain and the desperation.
While nothing can ever take away the pain of Guillermo and Maribel's loss, they find some solace in knowing that their son's death has saved other children's lives. This is Vivian Sue reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for Children.